Hey guys, I'm George, Director of Marketing for Components here at CORSAIR.
And I'm Matt, PM for Memory Products.
You guys know CORSAIR from our high-performance gaming keyboards, mice, and power supplies, but what you may not know is we got started doing really, really fast system cache and overclocking memory. This is the PM for that. He's gonna talk a little bit about how we got to where we are today with DDR4 and where we're going in the future with DDR5. So why don't you give us a quick rundown for the new guys. What's the difference between storage and memory?
Sure, absolutely, yeah. So that's an easy one, George. So one is about short-term data storage and the other is about long-term data storage. So DRAM or memory is about short-term data storage and SSD or your hard drive is all about that long-term data storage.
Okay, so effectively, if we use that kind of office analogy I've heard a couple people use before where your PC is an office, what's on your desk right now and that what you're working on right now is your short-term storage, your memory, and what's in the filing cabinet under the desk, that's your long-term storage or your hard drive. Explain, you know, what faster memory or more memory does for us.
Right, so I like to think of it as, let's use your analogy. You have your desk, you have one monitor. You can only do one thing at a time. Let's say you add more monitors, one monitor here, one monitor here. Now you have a whole array, say four monitors. You can use that same monitor analogy and compare that to CPU cores, and that then allows you to be doing multiple things simultaneously.
So to use that analogy then, we have multiple cores as our monitors, and we have our desktop space, which is the amount of RAM we have. So the more RAM we have and the faster the RAM we have, the more monitors we can use, the more cores we can feed at the same time.
Exactly. It's all about presenting that data as fast as possible to that worker using that same analogy.
Again. You guys will hear this referred to as bandwidth, the amount of bandwidth we can transfer between any part of the system, from your CPU to your GPU. Memory bandwidth is the measurement of this. So you'll see this in gigabytes a second and things like that. So that's the metric we're talking about. What's the difference between double data rate or dual data rate on DDR, which we're on DDR4 now, versus SDR way back in the day?
Yeah, absolutely. So with double data rate or DDR, you essentially get to read and write data two clock cycles at a time versus with single data rate, you only get to read and write on one clock cycle.
I've heard a lot of people conflate dual channel with double data rate, DDR and dual channel, not the same thing, even though there's two in both of them. So why don't you give people a rundown of what the difference between DDR and dual channel is?
Right, absolutely. So as we talked about prior, we had DDR or dual data rate, double data rate. That allows you to have more bandwidth. But now with dual channel, you essentially get to read and write to two modules simultaneously at the same time, further improving bandwidth and performance.
Oh, so that's cool. So that means not only do we go the double data rate on each module, but you can do two modules at the same time to get the bandwidth.
That's right.
One of the fun facts for you guys is that CORSAIR was one of the first guys to match twin kits. So we'd actually match modules to have similar overclocking performance, the same ICs, and guaranteed you'd get a matching set of ICs. Back in the day, if you went and bought two individual modules from, you know, CORSAIR, whoever, and they were single modules, they could have different ICs on them. You could have, you know, Elpida on one and Samsung on the other, or something like that, and they may not have a similar overclocking performance. We guarantee that if you buy a twin pack, you get the same thing in the box. We're one of the first guys to do that, and we still do it today for twin packs and even quad kits. So we have double data rate. We got from single data rate to double data rate. We got into dual channel there. What happened next?
Yeah, we're going through the passage of time here. So now we hit DDR2, essentially, and with DDR2 came an improvement in the total capacity, so we could have up to 4 gigabytes, and the speeds were hitting up to 800 megahertz.
800 megahertz.
Blazing fast.
DDR2 speeds, I believe I actually did some benchmarking to prove that that was beneficial at one point. Yeah, so DDR2, 800 megahertz, that's cool. What was next? Don't spoil it for me. I'm guessing DDR, DDR2.
Well, you know, George, that's a tough one, but I'm gonna tell you right now, it's definitely DDR3.
DDR3, and that would go up to about 8 gigabytes.
That's
and
right.
And what was it, 2133?
Yeah, that's right, correct, yeah.
Now today we're on DDR4, and I know we have modules out there that break 5,000.
Absolutely, yeah.
And we have 32 gig kits.
That's right,
buy.
Yep.
So let's see, we want DDR, DDR2,
yep.
DDR3, DDR4.
What's next?
What's next? If only there were some way to know.
Only I know. How could I predict it? I have no idea. Yeah, so DDR5 is going to be the next generation of DDR technology, as we've been highlighting through our journey through time, from DDR1 to DDR4. DDR5 is going to further bring improvements to speed and capacity. We're going to see speeds in DDR5 as base starting at what DDR4 was only the high-end, most overclocked versions of.
Right, we're starting at like 4800 or something.
That's right.
Right? So like we're starting DDR5 at 4800 megahertz. What's our capacity? We are at 32 gig kits today.
Yeah.
So what can we do on DDR5?
Well, DDR5, the sky's the limit right now. You know, if you want to build your PC with 64 gigs, 128 gigabytes of memory, those options may become available.
So the real question is, now that we have all this bandwidth coming and all this extra speed coming, why is that happening? Like, what's the benefit there?
Yeah, absolutely. So, you know, PCs are getting faster. There's more cores and CPUs. Data is everywhere. Data processing is huge. Constantly need to be feeding those processors. They're just so data hungry. Having higher performance memory that can serve those processors, serve those workers, as our analogy earlier, really helps benefit applications. Applications now are starting to evolve and actually utilize this higher speed and capacity and cores that technology is bringing to the table. So everything is finally really catching up, getting to higher speeds and capacities.
Right, I remember when the first dual core and quad core processors came out and almost all the games were just still optimized for single core, right? So you could have a really nice quad core processor and you'd be running it at, you know, 80 frames a second or whatever, and you'd look and it'd just be, you know, core zero, and cores one, two, and three are doing nothing. But now if you go look in your, you know, your 8-core processor, you're seeing all 8 cores are working.
Absolutely.
On these games.
Yeah, and it's like, today not only are you gaming, but you're doing so many other things, right? As content creators, you're gaming, you're editing videos, you're watching YouTube, you have 400 Chrome tabs open, whatever it may be.
Well, you stream, right?
I do, yeah.
So absolutely. Not only are you then gaming and running all the bandwidth and the CPU cycles and GPU cycles you need for that, but you're also capturing the video and streaming it live in 720p or 1080p.
Right.
So I think that with DDR5, what we're going to see as a benefit to real-world users is the extra speed and the extra bandwidth and the extra density, the extra capacity. Is going to be really, really beneficial for streamers in real-world gaming, actually fairly quickly.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. It's just happening now, and it's coming very soon.
Yeah. So one of the things that CORSAIR does really well is innovate, not just on what we're doing with speed and everything like that, but we actually have some pretty innovative technology. DHX technology is something we kind of invented, and it stands for dual-path heat exchange. And we invented it back in DDR1 days. I don't have any DDR1 dominators. Dominator 2, here, you can see the tall fins on the top of it. But this actually cools not just the memory itself, the ICs that get hot, but it cools the ground plane of the PCB as well, so that you're cooling the IC from both sides, the inside and the outside. Much more effective, this is patented. We have that on DDR2. We have that on DDR3, which made these replaceable fins part of the deal with Dominator GT. And even now with DDR4 with Dominator Platinum RGB with the Capellix LEDs and the cool anodized black coating and everything. DDR5 conceivably could run much hotter than DDR4. They've moved voltage regulation off the motherboard itself, and now it's on the chip. So you actually could be pumping a lot more heat.
Absolutely.
Into DDR5 modules.
Yeah, definitely. So, you know, building upon the DHX technology, one of the key benefits and values that CORSAIR brings to the table is that custom PCB, that IC sorting. And in that custom PCB with DHX technology, you get that copper element that helps transfer the heat from the modules to these, I think, spectacular looking heat sinks.
So in summary, we're faster, we're bigger, we're cooler. Coming when? Sometime this year?
Yeah, sometime this year. Maybe look towards the end of the year.
Towards the end of the year. Over the next few months, you're gonna see a lot more details from us on our social channels, on YouTube, on our blog, all the content we have. We are the world's best memory experts. We have established that time and time again. We have the fastest memory available you can buy. We're gonna keep that up with DDR5. So keep your eyes peeled. We'd love to show you guys what we have coming. Maybe something cool, maybe the next gen version of Dominators or its relatives. I'm George, thanks for watching.
I'm Matt. Guys, thank you for your time. Really appreciate it. Keep looking at all our socials for all the latest information.
Yep. And post your comments below and we'll make snide remarks. Talk to you later.
Thanks, guys.